This video is sponsored by Skillshare. Hello everyone! Through this tutorial, you will learn how to make your own Neon Effect PSD file. And with that file, you'll be able to recreate a colorful neon effect out of any shape or drawing with a couple of clicks. You'll also learn how to trace portraits to convert them to a neon effect like that. Please like the video and let's get started. Step 1. Prepare your workspace. Let's start by creating a new document. Set width to 3,300 pixels, height to 2,300 pixels with 300 resolution and RGB color mode. Then click Create. Now go to File, Place Embedded to import the wall image. You can download these tutorial assets from the video description below. Press Enter to confirm. And let's delete that background layer with a delete key. Now let's add some adjustment layers. First, create a levels layer. Change shadow to 15, midtones to 0.9, and highlights to 225. Create a brightness and contrast layer. Change brightness to 120 and contrast to 20. Please make sure that you're using the same exact values as mine. It's very important. And you'll know why in step 2. Finally, let's make a vibrance layer. Set vibrance to plus 60 and saturation plus 50. Now hold the Shift key and select all three layers. Then press Ctrl and G to group them. Name the group Adjustments, and let's import our object. First, select the wall layer, then go and create a solid color layer. Pick any color you want and click OK. Now go to File, Place Embedded, and import the example drawing. I will explain how to draw your own drawings later in step 3. Resize it, then press Enter to confirm. Now select both layers, then right-click and choose Convert to Smart Object. Double-click the Smart Object's thumbnail to open it. That color layer was used to force the Smart Object to have the same dimensions as the main document. If there is no color layer, your smart object will be something like that, and you will be limited to use this small space when reusing the effect again. Now we don't need the color layer anymore, just delete it with the delete key. Press Ctrl and S to update the smart object. Get back to your main document and let's move on to the next step. Step 2. Make the neon effect. First, select the example layer and hide it. With your layer selected, press Ctrl and J 3 times to duplicate it. Select the second layer and unhide it. Then go to Filter, Blur, and choose Gaussian Blur. Change amount to 20 pixels and click OK. Change blending mode to color and opacity to 25%. Collapse that layer, then select the third layer and unhide it. Apply the Gaussian Blur filter with 75 pixels amount, then click OK. Change blending mode to Lighten with 25% opacity. Collapse it and select the last layer and unhide it. Apply the Gaussian Blur this time with 150 pixels amount. Change blending mode to Screen with 25% opacity. Hold the Shift key and select all three layers. Then press Ctrl and G to group them. Name the group Glow, and let's make the neon effect. Just select the example layer and duplicate it twice with Ctrl and J. Select both duplicated layers and drag them over the Glow group. Select and unhide the bottom layer. Double-click the layer itself to open its layer styles. Click on Styles, and let's import the neon styles. To save your time, I had made this styles file especially for this tutorial. You can download it for free from the description below. Now select it and click Load. You'll get these four styles. Just select the first style and let's check it out. It has a combination of properties that gives you that neon effect together. For example, this inner shadow adds a white glow inside the neon tube. You can check them for any further understanding. Now click OK, and let's select the second layer and unhide it. double-click it to open its layer styles. Under Styles, choose the second style like that. This bevel and emboss property will distribute some random lighting around the tubes like that. And a 3D depth will be added to the tubes using the inner glow. And finally, a little white shadow will be added using the drop shadow. Now click OK, and let's move on. Select both layers, then press Ctrl and G to group them. Name the group as you want. And this will be your final result. If you hide your adjustment group, you will see a very big difference. And that's why we created them at the beginning. Now let's save this project as a PSD file for any future use. Just go to File and choose Save As. Select PSD from that drop-down menu and click Save. And that's it. But before moving to the next step, let's talk about our today's sponsor. Skillshare is a huge online learning platform with thousands of inspiring classes for all creative and curious people. They have tons of premium classes about graphic design, photography, illustration, filmmaking, freelancing, and much more. They offer almost 3,000 classes for Photoshop only. One class that I really love is the Photoshop Advanced Training Course from Daniel Scott. He has almost 14 hours of premium content for this class only. Unlike YouTube, Skillshare is 100% free of ads, so you can stay focused and follow wherever your creativity takes you. Plus, the first 1,000 people who use the link in my description will get a 1-month free trial of Skillshare Premium membership. Join Skillshare to boost your creativity today. Step 3. Update the neon effect completely with a single click. To do that, let's double-click our smart object to open it first. Hide this drawing first, then click the Pen tool. Change it to Shape with no fill. Set a color to the stroke, and change its size to any value between 35 to 50 pixels. Change the stroke to a solid line, with rounded corners and rounded caps. And finally set a line to center. Start drawing whatever you want like that. Press Ctrl and S to save it. Get back to your main document. As you can see, your neon effect will be completely updated with that press of a button. You can change the neon color to anything you want. Just get back to the smart object, select your layer, and change its color from here. Press Ctrl and S to save it. And here is the new color. Let's add some extra elements to our drawing. Using the Pen tool, let's draw three lines like this. Select all three lines layers and go to change their color from here. Select the star layer and change its color to white. Press Ctrl and S to get back to your main document. And this is the final result. Now let's move to the next step. Step 4. Add wires and fixings. This step is optional, and it's for intermediate level Photoshop users. Please skip this if you want. Let's start by selecting the Pen tool. And from the Options panel, leave all settings as before, and only change the stroke to 13 pixels. Click anywhere, then click and drag on any edge to bend your line like that. You can draw any number of lines with any shape you like, from any direction you want. Let's speed up this part. Now hold the Shift key and select all layers to group them. Drag that group under the Glow group. Now double-click it to open its layer style. Under the Styles menu, select the third style. As you can see, your lines will be turned into very realistic wires like that. Click OK to submit, and let's make the fixings. Select the brush tool first, and with a wires group selected, create a new layer. Change brush hardness to 100% and draw a circle on your layer like that. Double-click on your layer to apply the style 4 on it. Click OK and move it to the edge like this. please make sure the auto select is unchecked. With your layer selected, press Ctrl and T to resize it. Make sure that your layer is selected, then hold the Alt key until you see those double arrows. Now click and drag to take a copy to the other edge like that. Using the arrow keys, you can adjust the position perfectly. Keep duplicating it under all edges like that. Let's speed up this part. Select all layers by holding the Shift key, then group them like that. Now let's move to the final step. Extra tip: convert images to neon effect. First, double-click your smart layer to open it. Import your image from File, Place Embedded. Hide any other layer, then go and pick the pen tool. Set the stroke to 30 pixels. Start tracing the edges like this. This should depend on your skill in using the pen tool. After you finish your drawing, hide the image layer and press Ctrl and S to update your neon effect. And that's how I did it. You can complete your drawing with any colors you want to get results like this one. And that's it for today. Please like the video and subscribe for more free tutorials. Thanks for watching.